In winter, you need both electricity and heat. There's a way to guarantee both with a... Maybe you have it already in your home. The good news is, the heat is practically free. Hi, do-it-yourself champions, here in Norwood again. In our last video, we discussed how we can build an off-grid energy system using an old gasoline generator. Here you see how this system delivers one part of electricity and two parts of heat. The latter is usually discarded. Today, let's move forward and explore how we can recover heat from the exhaust gases in this combined heat and power or CHP unit. There's another equal part of heat from the hot engine, and that comes in another video. I told before, the heat is practically free. Of course, you pay for the gasoline, but all others use only the electricity of the genset and discard the heat. So that is why I say free. As we have seen, an internal combustion engine delivers heat at two temperatures. The combustion gases are very hot, whereas the heat from the engine is a bit under 100 degrees Celsius. So it is also possible to put them in series, where the least hot is for preheating, for example water, and the hotter is for bringing it to the final temperature. Or you keep them apart. For example, the heat from the engine is used to produce domestic hot water, and the combustion gases go into a sand battery. See videos 66 and 67. Now let's look at the gases. These toxic gases must not come in-house, even if outside they are all around us in traffic. A heat exchanger will lead them outside, but catch the heat. It can be as simple as an old radiator. This radiator from cast iron is made with vertical elements that are coupled with rubber gaskets that won't resist a very high temperature. Moreover, a comment warned me that the inside of the radiator may become dirty with the exhaust gases. So I came to the idea to solve both problems. I put a bit of water in the radiator. This will limit the temperature to 100 degrees Celsius and maybe also clean the gases in part. Not too much water, because that will create back pressure and make it difficult for the engine to blow the gases into the radiator. I will start with 10 centimeters and see what happens. When it starts to boil, the water will become less in the radiator. That doesn't matter because it's an experiment and I can try how much I may increase the water level. And it is easy to refill it from time to time. I have also to take care that the water will not flow back into the engine. But that is easy by installing the radiator below the exhaust. I asked a heating plumber and also a car mechanical worker about what they thought about this idea. They gave me precise advice. In the hardware shop, you must have clear ideas about the parts which you want. They have other clients and they are not always used to give advice for weird experiments. So before showing my results, I want to explain why I do all these weird experiments and not just living like a decent consumer. There are so many nice things on the market. Isn't that enough? Well, I think it isn't. If we are in this situation where the urgency of the climate is so high and the change in lifestyle is so slow, then it is clear something must change. And it is not only climate. Also, the scarcity plays a role. That causes high prices for energy and unstable grids. And if something must change and nobody changes, why don't we start change by ourselves? That has also the advantage that we can prepare. We will increase our freedom and make things that are not in the shops, thanks to the creativity of our mind. Take this project for example. When I try to explain in hardware shop why I need these parts, they watch me with such large eyes? Also, why isn't this simple CHP for do-it-yourself on YouTube? Is it so logical to discard 2/3 of the energy in the gasoline? And yet, look to the extreme situations like in Ukraine and in Cuba. This week, the former lost in 1 week many of their power plants. The latter had a massive blackout for 11 million of people, caused by a grid that hasn't enough resources to go with the demand. In Ukraine, there's not only dark, but also cold. This micro CHP can give here electricity and heat, just with simple materials. I can also imagine that small entrepreneurs in extreme situations can specialize in this technology and help their own community. The best way to flourish yourself is to do things that others appreciate. I live in a much less extreme situation, but also in Europe and many other parts of the world, there is a grid that doesn't keep pace with a very high growth in demand of electricity. This is caused by switching from coal, oil and gas to electricity. And because we are incentivized to heat with heat pumps and to drive electric. So also in this moderate environment, I see many worries about security of energy supply, and I find it anyway irrational to use close to 100% of the energy in fossil fuels rather than only 30%. So that's the reason that I do weird experiments. It's very difficult to find videos about it on YouTube. I hope you appreciate it. If so, subscribe to the channel and look to the many videos that are going to come out in a dedicated playlist on this project. If you share it with your friends and with people that need electricity and heat, then you will help to grow my channel, and I will see that this is a good topic to continue my weird experiments. So let's now see what I did this week. Five and a half minutes. Let's stop here. In our next video, we will leave this subject for a moment to avoid focusing too much.
I'm a long lost soul traveling all around this world. Got 7 different children.
Let's instead maintain our bird's eye view and explore heat recovery from the engine itself. Stay tuned as we build this off-grid energy system step by step. Don't forget to comment with your thoughts and subscribe to motivate me to continue with this project. The winter is just starting and will be probably colder than in the previous years. See you next time and stay warm.
And the sun came up on the Mississippi Mile. Trouble voices and desperate smiles. And I'm calling.